Rahim nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem amma ba'd Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal alimul hakim Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli Rabbi yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammimhu lana bil khair ya fattahu ya fattahu ya fattah Qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fil Qur'an al-Majid wal Furqan al-Hamid بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون Respected brothers and elders, mothers and sisters in Islam, it is through the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that each and every one of us are in this month of Ramadan. There are many people who wanted to be in the month of Ramadan but they could not even reach this month. But there were many who were with us last year, but they are not with us anymore. For us to have this opportunity and to find this month of Ramadan once again in our life is truly a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give barakah and blessings in the remaining days of siyam and qiyam that we have. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us, all of our... Is there any physician or doctor that can help out in outside? Okay, thank you. Shukran. Jazakallah khair. I was thinking the whole mashr is going to get out. Alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for the brother or sister who is in the problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us shifa and health and cure. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our gathering mubarak and blessed, brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, as we begin this month of Ramadan, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of us and our families on this day of Jum'ah. I want to share a message with you related to hope and encouragement in this month of Ramadan. When you look at the month of Ramadan Islamically or through history, you will always find that this month of Ramadan always has given this ummah, this nation, hope and encouragement. Times when we thought that this ummah or this nation or Muslims will not be able to accomplish anything, but Ramadan gave us the best. And I even tend to say sometimes, even though there is no thing sense as miracles, but the month of Ramadan is actually to get your dreams fulfilled. There are many of us sitting in this room, visions and things that they want to accomplish in their lives. But there are certain hurdles. And even sometimes our own self, we are the hurdle of thinking that they may never become possible. But brothers and sisters, my message for today in this Jum'ah, in the first Jum'ah of Ramadan, is to give you a message that the month of Ramadan is a month to get your dreams fulfilled. It is a time to get hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is a month of victory for the Muslims in so many places. And I want to share with you three examples only from the prophetic seerah, from the life of the Prophet ﷺ and the history of Islam. When you look at the beginning of Islam, when you look at the Muslims in Mecca, and Muslims were living in Mecca at a time when they were persecuted, when they were in the most difficult of the times. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enriched the Muslims and granted them the favor of Qur'an, and Qur'an itself was one of the greatest favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that uplifted the spirits of the Muslims. When the Muslims were so low, when they did not have anything around them, the Qur'an became the means of their solution in so many difficulties. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us in the Qur'an, قَدْرِ وَمَا أَذْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. All of these beautiful ayats of the Qur'an are attaching the book of Allah with the month of Ramadan. That the revelation of Qur'an, the wahi itself, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق, the five ayats which began upon the Prophet ﷺ, the nabuwa, the prophecy, was given to Rasulullah ﷺ in the month of Ramadan. Which shows hope to us, brothers and sisters, that indeed the victory of the Muslims, the strength of the Muslims, lie upon our attachment to the Qur'an and this month of Ramadan itself. Number two, brothers and sisters, there is an incident in Islam which is known as the Day of Badr. The Day of Badr was a day where the Muslims were not even one-third equivalent to the powers of Quraysh. They were not even one-fourth equipped as much as the Quraysh were. The Muslims were only 313 in number. They were so weak that they barely had two camels to ride upon. They barely had few individuals to cover themselves. And that's why on the 17th of Ramadan, on the morning of Friday, the second year of the Hijrah of the Prophet ﷺ, in the place of Badr, the Nabi of Allah ﷺ is lining these 300. I remember it was the time of Fajr. It was the 17th of Ramadan. It was the day of Jum'ah. It was the second year of the migration. And the Nabi of Allah ﷺ is lining these 313 individuals in a line to face 1,000 strong of the Quraysh. And the Prophet ﷺ has risen his hands above his head. And there's only two times in his life, according to hadith, that he made dua like this. This dua is made in extreme need. When you need something dearly. When you need something that you can't live without. It was the morning of the day of Badr. And it was the day of Arafah, the Hajj of Rasulullah ﷺ. Two times he made dua like this. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, I saw my Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had his hands up like this. The sheet that was covering his body fell to the ground. And he was making dua and he was telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, I have brought in front of you a group of few individuals who are weak and they can barely cover themselves. And they have no shoes to cover their feet and no armors to protect their bodies. And they have no weapons to protect themselves and their loved ones. Oh Allah, if this jama'ah, if this small group of individuals do not remain on the face of this earth, oh Allah, there will be me. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu himself said, we all cried. And when he cried so much, he said, I covered him from the back, the sheet that had fallen to the ground. And I said, enough ya Rasulullah, enough ya Rasulullah. It's enough of prayers, O Prophet of Allah. And all of a sudden I saw a smile on the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I asked, O Nabi of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is the morning of the 17th of Ramadan, a day of Jum'ah, in the battlefield of Badr, and the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just sent the revelation through Jibreel alayhi salam, وَيُمِدُّكُمْ بِأَلْفِ بِثَلَاثَةِ آلَافٍ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكِ مُطْرِفِينَ, that we have helped you with 3,000 angels coming for your help, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And not only this, Allah says in the Quran, I myself will come for the help of the believers. And it is the day that the Quran says to be Yawmul Furqan, the day that differentiates between haqq and batil, the day that differentiates between right and wrong. Brothers and sisters, when we see no possibility, when we see that it is impossible, the month of Ramadan is to make the impossible possible through our dua and through our attachment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam and the month of Ramadan has shown us so much victory, brothers and sisters. Month of Ramadan is the month to bring hope with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Month of Ramadan is a time to get your needs and necessities from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes we can't even say it publicly, but it's between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know it, brothers and sisters. Take this message back home, that this month of Ramadan is the month to get all of your needs fulfilled from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the month to get all of your supplications fulfilled from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we begin with revelation. We begin with wahi. We begin with Quran in the month of Ramadan. The greatest in'am for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A guide that we can keep till every moment of our lives. The Quran as our guide, the Quran as our hadi, the Quran as a means of our salvation. As the Quran, Rasulullah ﷺ said, I leave behind you Quran, I leave behind you my way, the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brothers and sisters, the first victory for the Muslims in Ramadan is the Quran itself. That when the entire humanity was misguided, when the humanity would lick the blood of their enemies, when the humanity would fight with their enemies for generations to come, when the people would take the livers of their animal and bite them because of power and fearness that they would show others, that same ummah was guided through Quran. They were guided through the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first victory for the believers. The second victory for the believers, the day of Badr, when you saw everything means in strength, in everything that you can imagine, But Allah's help is absolute. When Allah's help is there, then nothing can defeat an individual. So knowing that the power of Allah is with us when we attach ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And brothers and sisters, my last and my third issue that I mentioned to you in the history of Islam, and there are so much that I can talk about upon the day of Ramadan. But the third victory that the Quran talks about himself itself, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so openly mentioned to us, that the Prophet 53 years of his life. He was born in Mecca. He was raised in Mecca. He was born in the year known as the year of elephants. When Abraha came and attacked the Kaaba, that was the year of the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He lived within Mecca for 40 years as an individual known as As-Sadiq al-Amin. Allahu Akbar, brothers and sisters. A point to take back. Before Nabuwa, before prophecy, before revelation, he was already known as As-Sadiq al-Amin. His characteristics were so beautiful that people proclaimed that he was As-Sadiq al-Amin. And at the age of 40, when he receives the revelation, when the Prophet of Allah ﷺ becomes the Nabi of Allah, he begins to invite towards the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same people who cherished him, the people who loved him, the people who persecute the Nabi of Allah ﷺ, to an extent that his own companions for days and days had nothing to eat and survive upon. They had to go towards Habsha, Abyssinian Ethiopia of that time, and they came back. The Prophet of Allah ﷺ and Sahaba were boycotted for 3 years. For many of us, we missed that portion of history. They were put inside a small valley of Abi Talib, known as Shaybi Abi Talib, a mile distance from the Kaaba. It is mentioned in hadith that the cries of children and women could be heard inside the Kaaba because of hunger. For 3 years they had nothing, when they were even had to eat the leaves of the trees. So much difficulties that the Muslim bared inside the Mecca for 13 years continuously. And when they began to plan to assassinate the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he finally migrated towards Medina. He left towards Medina. There was no hopes for Mecca, his land where he loved so much. When he's making hijrah, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam looks back at the mountain, and he looks at the mountain and he sees the entire city of Mecca, and he says, "Oh Mecca, I love you. For it was not for the people of Quraysh, I would have never left you. If it was not for the people of Quraysh taking me out of my own land, oh Mecca, I would have never left you." And with a such big heart, the Prophet ﷺ left the city of Mecca. He reached 8 years. Allah gave Muslims something. After 8 years of leaving Mecca, after 8 years of not seeing the Kaaba, after 8 years of being deprived of doing Umrah and visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals the ayah of the Quran, "Inna fatahna laka fatham mubina." Surah Fatha, the chapter of the victory of the Muslims, revealed on the day of Hudaybiyah, to give the glad tiding to the Muslims that the Muslims will become victorious and they will enter inside Mecca for the first time with their heads up. They can openly say that they are Muslims and they will not be persecuted. They can openly give the adhan, but they will not be beaten like Bilal bin Rabah in the streets of Mecca. They can openly say La ilaha illallah, and their bodies will not be spited with the charcoals that will openly say La ilaha illallah, and their bodies would not be cut into pieces like Sumayya radiallahu anha, the first woman who gave her life for Islam, when her body was cut into two by Abu Jahl because of saying La ilaha illallah. They would not be hungry and thirsty anymore for saying La ilaha illallah. And it was after 8 years, brothers and sisters. It was the day in Ramadan. Some say it was the 23rd of Ramadan. The third, on the 23rd of Ramadan, according to some of the historians, was the day that Rasulullah ﷺ entered inside Mecca. It was the day that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Muslims victorious and returned Mecca back to the Muslims. And subhanAllah, with all of this victory, brothers and sisters, I want to share something with you regarding the humbleness and the humility of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Sahaba have mentioned that when the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered Mecca, and when he reached the city of Mecca, and imagine, he loved the city so dearly. He was persecuted in such a manner that his own daughter Zainab radiallahu anha was stabbed, where her child passed away in her womb. And with that same pain for many years, his own daughter Zainab radiallahu anha passed away. For all the difficulties that the Quraysh had given him, for 13 years continuous, while he was in Mecca, and then 8 years while he was in Medina, and now finally it is the chance for him to walk inside Mecca. And of course, this is a place which you love so dearly, and all the people who have done you all harms are standing in front of you. Many accepted Islam, some had not accepted Islam. But I want to share with you from the history and the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ. It is mentioned in the books of seerah, in the life of the Prophet ﷺ. His forehead was touching the back of the camel. For what reason? Humility and humbleness. He did not enter Mecca as a person with pride and arrogance. But he only had that indeed it is Allah who gave us the victory. It is Allah who took us from the depth of the disgrace to the izzat and respect and dignity that the humanity has seen for the Muslims. And that was the day when Rasulullah ﷺ entered inside Mecca, when the people of Mecca were hiding themselves. And they were thinking that when nations take over nations, women are raped, children are taken as captives, men are killed, and everyone was hiding. But when the Nabi of Allah ﷺ entered inside, he made an announcement, just like Yusuf alayhi salam made an announcement, chapter number 12, when he was returning back to his brothers, when he had become the king of the area of Egypt, of treasury, he said, لا تثريب عليكم اليوم, my brothers and sisters, none of you will be harmed. None of you will be harmed. That was the akhlaq and the manner of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he knew that the victory and success was not mine. It was Allah who gave us this victory and success. It is Allah who gave us that power and strength. It is not me individually who earned this success and this power. And what happened? Their hearts melted and all of them accepted Islam. A woman known as Hinda, who bit the liver of Hamza radiallahu anhu on the day of Uhud, and she says, now my heart is at ease. On the day of Uhud, she took the liver of the uncle of Rasulullah ﷺ from his body, and she bit it for the barbaric life that they were living before Islam. And she says, now my heart, the month of Ramadan is a month to get any of us fulfilled, which we thought that can never be possible. The month of Ramadan is to get your dua and your needs and necessities answered from the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, it is us that we don't ask Allah. Allah is ready to give us. The doors and the treasures of Allah are open. It is us that we have forgotten to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The month of Ramadan, take back a few messages from this khutbah, brothers and sisters. The month of Ramadan is the month of possibilities. Ask Allah to take your needs and fulfill your needs. The month of Ramadan is the month of hope. The month of Ramadan is the month of encouragement. The month of Ramadan is the month of victory within your own selves. Make your heart victorious. Come is with you, brothers and sisters. This is the month that we can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our needs. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen our yaqeen and our belief. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this month of Ramadan from all of us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah gives us strength in our faith, in our Quran, in our iman, in our sunnah, and allow us to live our life according to the Quran and the beautiful life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Brothers and sisters, two very quick announcements. Alhamdulillah, with the tawfiq and the strength from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Islamic Center of Long Island in the previous many decades have grown to such a level that it's serving not only Long Island but New York and even national things that Islamic Center of Long Island is doing. The brothers and sisters who have been a part of this organization for many years, and those brothers even till now, you have been a great part of this community, helping and supporting us every moment of your life. May Allah bless you and reward you and increase for you at every fold of your life. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most generous of the human beings, but his generosity increased many fold in the month of Ramadan. Our mother Aisha radiallahu anha tells us this, that he was the most generous person, but in the month of Ramadan his generosity increased many folds. I humbly request you, brothers and sisters, this is the house of Allah. Allah promises to take care of it. Like he sent us in Ali, can become the reasons of doing anything for this house of Allah, it is an honor for Allah for me. I'm not doing any favor on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a favor of Allah for me that Allah used my time, my wealth, and my energy for His house, because this is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters. That's why I humbly request that, alhamdulillah, all of you have been generously giving this house of Allah for many, many years. But I humbly request to pledge in this month of Ramadan something more than usual. for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as your ajr are multiplied many, many times. If we can all, inshallah, and of course this is not compulsory, but if all of us can pledge that, you know what, I'll put $100 every Jummah in Ramadan, that is something more than what I do usually, but for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is Kareem. Allah is Kareem in a way that He will return many, many folds to you. I make this intention, and if you can personally do this, Allah will reward you in many, many folds. And the ajr and reward for this ummah. May Allah increase for us, allow us this to practice this in our lives, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our qiyam and our siyam and our sadaqat. Wa ma alayna illa al-balagh.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله علي ذاتي أذل العلم وسيل حلمي كثير الغفران جميل الثناء جزيل الأطاء مجيب الدعاء أميم الإحسان سري الحساب شديد العقاب أليم العذاب عزيز السلطان ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث إلى الأسود والأحمر المنوط بشرح صدري ورفع ذكر وصلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين هم خلاصة العرب الأربعة وخير الخلائق بعد الأنبياء أما بعد فيا أيها الناس وحدوا الله فإن التوحيد رأس التعاد واتقوا الله فإن التقوى ملات الحسنات وعليكم بالسنة فإن سنة تهدي إلى الإطاعة ومن أطاع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى وإياكم والبدعة فإن البدعة تهدي إلى المعصية ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى وعليكم بالصدق فإن الصدق ينجي والكذب يهلك وعليكم بالإحسان فإن الله يحب المحسنين ولا تقنطوا من رحمة الله فإنه أرحم الراحمين ولا تحبوا الدنيا فتكونوا من الخاسرين ألا وإن نفس لن تموت حتى تستقبل رزقها اتقوا الله واجملوا في طلبه وتوكل عليه فان الله يحب المتوكلين ودعوه فان ربكم مجيب الداعين واستغفروه يمددكم باموال وبنين اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا ايها الذين امنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون بارك الله لنا ولكم في القران العظيم ونفعنا واياكم بالايه وذكر الحكيم استغفر الله الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعصيه فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على سيدنا مولانا محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشهدهم في أمر الله عمر وأستقم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسر رسوله رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر للعباس ولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا. الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم من بعدي غرضا، فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضهم ابغي ابغضهم ان الله يامر بالعدل والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله